Finally tonight, a profile of a pair of chefs who want to change what kids eat. There's a growing effort to tackle the problem of childhood obesity in schools. Toward that end, the Senate passed a $4.5 billion child nutrition bill yesterday that funds programs for the next 10 years and creates new standards to improve the kinds of food that are offered in school. NewsHour health correspondent Betty Ann Bowser reports on two chefs who want to make good on that promise. The health unit is a partnership with the Robert Wood Johnson Foundation.
We talked about the mother sauces yesterday. Hollandaise. What does Hollandaise go over?
Andrea Martin knows her way around a Hollandaise sauce.
What happens is called blooming. The salt flavor gets bigger and bigger and bigger.
And Kate Adamick knows the subtleties of spices. Between the two of them, Chef Andrea and Chef Kate have cooked their way through enough coca van and beef Wellington to merit their own show on the Food Network.
Where does salt come from?
But these days, the two classically trained chefs from New York City have chosen a far more mundane place to showcase their talents. They're taking their culinary knowledge on the road to the public school lunchrooms of America and the people who prepare food for the kids who eat there. And here's one of the reasons why.
The Centers for Disease Control says that one-third to one-half of our children born since the year 2000 will acquire type 2 diabetes in their lifetime, because the Centers for Disease Control says that this is the first generation in American history to have a shorter life expectancy than their parents because of diet-related illness.
This summer, Adamick and Martin ran a boot camp for chefs at Rangeview High School in Aurora, Colorado, just outside of Denver. It was just one of a series put on around the state, sponsored in part by the Colorado Department of Health and the Colorado Health Foundation. The goal? Improve the nutrition in public school lunchrooms. The Centers for Disease Control say the Mile High State is the leanest in the country. But recent studies have shown that even here in healthy Colorado, obesity is a growing problem among Black and Hispanic children. Eric Acco is in charge of nutrition programs for the state health department.
When you're looking at all of the data, such as poverty and lack of access to fresh fruits and vegetables, lack of access to outdoor recreation and parks and that sort of thing, we have rates that are just as bad as some parts of the South.
Many Aurora school children come from poor families whose income is so low they qualify for the federal free breakfast and lunch program. That means two of their meals each day are eaten at school.
Pan frying, we're talking about the fat coming halfway up the item. Are these techniques that we're going to be thinking about for our schools? Absolutely not. We don't do this in our schools.
Boot camp chefs are taught to stay away from deep frying and processed foods. The emphasis here is on cooking fresh food from scratch. Recipes include those for yellow squash, cauliflower, and lentils.
The issue is not the kids won't eat it. The issue is the adults think the kids won't eat it. And it's almost universal that we see the kids really do eat it.
So are these kids going to eat squash, cauliflower, lentils?
I think it's the idea of just basically exposing them to it.
Lisa Samuel cooks for kids in an Aurora elementary school. She's big on one of the boot camp's important concepts. It's called stealth health.
We've learned how to disguise some of the fruits and the vegetables in the food.
What's the best trick you learned?
How to make a spaghetti sauce and put carrots and celery and onions and zucchini, and we blend it up, and it's still fabulous red sauce.
Why is it important to have the language of the kitchen in your lives?
The boot camp chefs also get instructions similar to what's taught in top professional cooking schools.
We use a lot of culinary language. We move into knife skills. We give them French terms to understand what they're actually doing. We do basic cooking techniques with them. We put them in their chef whites. We had kids walk by the classroom the other day and they said, oh, look at all the chefs in the room. So we start to give them a sense of identity.
As a school cook for 26 years, Janice Adams has watched with alarm as her students' waistlines have expanded. Now she wants to bring a sea change to her lunchroom.
we have to be careful about what we put in our bodies and what the kids are getting in their bodies. These are the kids that's going to have to take care of us someday. And if we don't watch what we're putting into them, how can they take care of us?
It's the difference between.
Shannon Solomon, who's just lost over 100 pounds, is also the mother of five children and inspired after her week at boot camp.
I feel very empowered. I want to bring my education to the kids. That's where my heart, that's where my passion is. I want to bring the education. Five-star restaurants are great, and I love the chef learning I had right now, but impacting the lives of our children and bringing that to our school district, it's the most important thing to me right now in my life.
Shannon Solomon.
Graduation day. Each new chef left with a framed diploma and a whole new framework for school food. And now, with the real prospect of millions of new dollars coming from Washington to improve nutrition, they might just have a chance to make lentils and cauliflower staples on the lunchroom menu.